Social media accounts are on the hot seat. Senator Richard Blumenthal is demanding changes after a Facebook whistleblower testified before Congress today. News 12 Connecticut's John Craven in our newsroom. John, he says it's time to crack down.
Well, Della, Senator Blumenthal wants to change how these platforms operate, specifically what content they decide to show you. It comes after explosive testimony today from an insider.
They're the biggest social media platforms in the world, Facebook and Instagram. On Capitol Hill, Senator Richard Blumenthal put both on the hot seat.
Facebook and big tech are facing a big tobacco moment, a moment of reckoning.
Senators heard from Francis Haugen, a whistleblower who says parents should be afraid.
The company's leadership knows how to make Facebook and Instagram safer, but won't make the necessary changes because they have put their astronomical profits before people.
Haugen produced internal research showing Facebook knows its algorithms recommend misinformation and dangerous content.
The second graphic displays an anti-tip, that is, a tip specifically designed to encourage and promote anorexia.
Blumenthal's office posed as a 13-year-old girl on Instagram. The app recommended accounts called Eternally Starved, I Have to Be Thin, and Skin and Bones.
The witness today, the whistleblower, confirmed it, that that experience is not unusual.
Today, Facebook tweeting out that Haugen did not work directly on child safety and has no direct knowledge of the topic from her work at Facebook.
Even with the most sophisticated technology, which I believe we deploy, even with the tens of thousands of people that we employ to try and maintain safety and integrity on our platform, you're right, Brian, we're never going to be absolutely on top of this 100% of the time.
Well, that is not good enough for Senator Blumenthal. He is now pushing for several new laws to control how social media platforms interact with kids. Those bills have a lot of Republican support, too. In the newsroom, John Craven, News 12, Connecticut.
Thank you, John.